association is a very historic association, started as early as in 1959 by Srimati Rukmini Devi Arunde. I don't know how many of you have heard of this great lady, a humanist and an artist, and it is indeed a privilege to be associated with this movement. Vegetarianism for me is a way of life, and I cannot conceive of any other way of life. But if one were to define being a vegetarian, what is being a vegetarian? So I was looking up different definitions of what is a vegetarian, and the one that I found most attractive was given by a 5-year-old child. The child said, "I don't want to eat anything that will have babies." That's a very, very simple way of putting it, rather a simplistic way of putting things. But if you look at it deeply, that is the essence of being a vegetarian, in the sense of a spirit of vegetarianism. You don't want anything to come to an end, but you want to keep the cycle of life moving. So anything that is going to have children, that is going to have babies, you don't want to eat that and cut short its lifespan. That in essence to me summed up what was being a vegetarian. Luckily today, being a vegetarian is a fashionable term. Wherever you go, people talk about being environmentally friendly, and therefore it is fashionable to being called a vegetarian, and now the term has expanded to being called a vegan also. I don't know how many of you are familiar with the term veganism. I must give you an interesting episode that I had when I travel abroad. For us, vegetarian is excluding anything which is meat or fish oriented. But if you were to go abroad and say, ask for a vegetarian dish, in many places you will be served dishes that include fish, that include meat, different kinds of meat. And that's when I understood that the definition of vegetarian changes from place to place. And there are many reasons for this. People believe that historically, why do people eat non-vegetarian food? In fact, Mr. Kaur mentioned that India is one of the earliest places where the concept of vegetarianism was started. India, Greece, and a few other places in the world was when people started thinking of vegetarianism as a concept. And it is in colder parts of the world that people started eating meat, and that was more for climatic compulsions and for dietary restrictions. They needed the warmth that meat could give them to sustain. But what I would urge you to believe is that today we are in different times. I know there are many children here who are not very interested in what I am talking about, but if you could give me just 2 minutes of your time. Today we are at a time when you have to think about the welfare of everything around us. And therefore, for me, the definition of vegetarian is not just what that little girl said, but in addition, doing everything that we can to prevent inflicting pain on another living being. There are living beings, and there are living beings that feel pain. You may ask, a plant is a living being. If you are a vegetarian, do you not eat a plant? Is that not a living being? Are you not cutting short its life? But no, there is a difference. What is the difference between an animal and a plant? Is that my cue? The children should probably say, if they have to move out of class when the bell rings, this auntie should stop talking when the bell rings. Give me 1 minute more, just 1 minute more. What is the difference between an animal and a plant? An animal, children, has a nervous system. The nervous system means that when you inflict pain on it, it feels pain. A plant does not have a brain or a nervous system. Therefore, notwithstanding that you may cut a plant or you may cook a plant or you may eat a plant, அதுக்கு வலிக்காது, பிளான்ட்டுக்கு வலிக்காது. ஆனிமலுக்கு குத்தினா கட் பண்ணால் வலிக்கும். தேட் இஸ் அ டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் பிட்வீன் அ பிளான்ட் அண்ட் அன் ஆனிமல். ஹவ் யூ ஆல் ஹர்ட் ஆஃப் த மியூசிக் பேண்ட் த பீட்டில்ஸ்? தெர் வாஸ் அ வெரி ஃபேமஸ் மியூசிஷியன் பை த நேம் ஆஃப் பால் மெக்கார்ட்னி, ஹூ இஸ் பார்ட் ஆஃப் த பீட்டில்ஸ். அண்ட் ஹி செட் தட் தி ஆனிமல்ஸ் கோ த்ரூ அ லாட் ஆஃப் பெயின் வென் தே ஆர் பீங் ஸ்லாட்டர்ட் டு பி ப்ராட் டு யுவர் டின்னர் டேபிள். And he said, if all these slaughter houses have glass walls, then everybody would become vegetarian. Because then you can see the pain that the animals go through when they are being slaughtered. I'm not going to take much more of your time. The bell is gone. So I will stop with this. I had prepared something more in terms of information, but I will conclude by saying that it's all in your mind. It's a question of your attitude. It's a question of your inclination. Think vegetarian, because that in effect means that you value the life around you. You value the life of every little being around you and you equate it to your life. We don't like to feel pain. Just like that, we don't like to inflict pain on another person. Thank you for this opportunity. Good morning and have a great rest of the day. Thank you.
இதுவரை யாருமே சொல்லாத ஒரு கருத்தை ஜஸ்டிஸ் அவர்கள் சொல்லியிருக்கின்றார்கள். சில பேர் நான்வெஜ் சாப்பிட்றவங்க என்ன சொல்லுவாங்க, நம்ம வந்து வெஜிடபிளை கட் பண்ணுறோம், அதை குக் பண்ணுறோம், அதுக்கு வந்து வலிக்காதா போவாதான்னு. அதுக்கு சரியான ஒரு உதாரணம் சொன்னாங்க, அனிமல்ஸுக்கெல்லாம் பகுத்தறிவு, அறிவு, உணர்வு அதெல்லாம் இருக்குது. ஆனால் மரம் செடி கொடிகளுக்கு பகுத்தறிவு கிடையாது, அதற்கு வலிக்காது. அந்த ஒரு தன்மையை ஆண்டவன் கொடுத்திருக்கின்றான். அதனால் இந்த பயிர்கள் எல்லாம் வந்து அவங்களுக்கு எந்த விதமான வலியோ துன்பமோ ஏற்படாது. அது நாம் சாப்பிடுவதற்காகவே படைக்கப்பட்ட பொருட்கள். இந்த ஒரு கருத்தை இதுவரை யாருமே சொல்லவில்லை.